are live with Zerb at Tomorrowland Brazil. How are you?
I'm good.
Excellent. All right, come on. Where do we start? It's Tomorrowland Brazil. You're here in Sao Paulo. Are you buzzing? Are you excited? How's your heart? Can I feel it? Yes, excited. Talk to me.
Yeah, we were together, you know, asked me about Tomorrowland Brazil last time in Belgium. And it was like beyond my expectations, you know, it was crazy today, crazy.
Tell me what you saw.
I don't know even like where to start, but it was just like a crowd. My stage was completely full, a lot of people.
You sound surprised. You sound surprised.
I mean, like, you know, you always like, you have like a lot of thoughts about it, like how it's gonna be. So when you go into the stage and you see like a lot of people, and wherever you do, like you raise your hand, people just go with you and are like, okay, that's happening, you know? Festivals are always amazing, and Tomorrowland especially, it's one of the best festivals in the world. And I played in Belgium, it was completely crazy. Mm-hmm. And being here in Brazil, in my hometown, playing, it was one of the best moments of my life.
Tell me, musically, what track went super well? What absolutely lit up the crowd?
There were like a lot of them, but...
All right. That's what you're hit making now. You're allowed to do that. Oh, here's the track I made with Coldplay. All right, here's Mwaki. It's all right, I've got another one. Tell me.
The Coldplay track was actually crazy. It was like, I mean, like I played all of my sets, but to the day it was really special. And I saw like, I was playing, I was like, okay, this is special. And then after when I got into like the green room, my manager, he was like, you gotta see this. And he showed me a video of a guy wearing the same outfit as the music video, like wearing the same shirt, the same like helmet, not a helmet, like a mask, you know, of the music video he was wearing.
In the festival.
Yeah, in the festival, yeah. So we have like a video of this guy like wearing the same outfit as the music video while I was playing the track.
How does that make you feel? Because they've seen that, you've inspired them, they've done that and brought it to the festival because of you.
Yeah, it's, for me it's so special. Like, as I said, like, you never know when you go into a festival, because festivals, you know, like there's a lot of stage, a lot of like, great artists playing, so you always think about like, you think about yourself like, is it gonna be good? People are gonna come to see me. And when you see like people that actually love your music and are here for you, it's, so I don't have words to describe.
This feels like you're going to have to start to get used to this, because it doesn't feel like you're used to this yet, right? I know it's all quite new, but
yeah,
are you settling into this kind of fame?
Yeah, everything is new for me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So have you walked around the festival today?
No, not really. Yeah.
But if you did, do you think people would stop you? They'd recognize you now?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah? How do you handle that?
I mean, I'm just gonna be happy about it. Like, I had a huge moment in Brazil a few years ago. I have like this big moment in Brazil where I was playing like all over the country, and then like the things were not going really well. I was really like uninspired, you know, like I was thinking about giving up, and I tell like in my social media about this, like I was almost giving up about my career, and then my song Mwak came and was like one of the biggest records in the whole world, and it was one of the craziest moments of my life where my life completely changed. And I'm living this moment right now, so everything, it seems new. Although like I lived there, I lived that before.
Yeah.
Now everything seems new.
Is everything like 100 kilometers an hour? It's so fast. Yeah. So tour life. How do you deal with tour life?
You know, tour life was I mean like tour life was hard for me because I used to travel by myself. Nowadays, I never travel by myself. I always travel with. I mean like I didn't have like a whole crew. Nowadays, like my manager is one of my best friends. My photographer is one of my best friends. So I'm just like traveling all over the world, going to all of those countries, meeting like new people with my best friends. So you can imagine, like,
it's good times.
It's good times. I'm living the best moment of my life.
They get the rider, you do the stage, yeah?
Yeah, you
can have those. All right, let's talk about music. Let's talk about, we know what you've got. What don't we know you've got? So what's hidden on the hard drive?
Oh man.
Last time
I couldn't say about the Coldplay thing, and I told you.
I know, so I'm asking again.
No, I can't say. Like
you can't.
You heard my manager like telling the.
It's not here. He's not here. Don't worry about him.
What I can say is, nowadays, who follow me, they know that I'm doing every step that I make is like big steps. I'm working with big artists. So what I can say is like, you can expect only big things from me. Like I'm working with my favorite artists from all over the world. The biggest artists from all over the world. So I can't say that much.
Come on, give me something to, come on, no.
Can I say it? I have a song. I have a song with Wiz Khalifa. It's one of my favorite songs.
This is funny. So yeah, okay. I wasn't expecting that. No, that was not who I was expecting you to say. Fantastic.
Yeah.
This year? Next year?
I hope this year.
Okay. Yeah. Fingers crossed. Awesome. All right.
One more of my favorite songs, and I played that song for my friends for the first time. I was like, you gotta hear the song. Mm-hmm. It's my collab with Wiz Khalifa, nobody heard before. And I played for them. They heard it. It was like, they were like, this is so good. Okay. Like a few weeks later, we were together and we had like, a CDJ. Yeah. Like, we're just like doing like a friends party. And I played a song. And when I was playing that song, the bar went off. So everybody was like, oh. But was while I was playing the song, so they just kept singing. I was like, you heard the song one time.
Oh,
and
it's that kind
singing.
Of song, right?
Yeah, it's that kind of song.
That's called
that's
an
what
earworm.
I can
say. That's an earworm.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I can say.
It's in there, good.
But we have like more collaborations in that song. It's a huge song.
Dude, this is insane.
That's what I can say.
It's insane.
It's already like.
I'm grateful,
really
I'm grateful.
Yeah.
All right, so let's look to wrap this up. We're in Brazil. I've not tasted so much Brazilian food, all right? But what do I need to try? Tell me, give me some things I need to go out to a restaurant and eat.
The barbecue.
The barbecue?
Yeah.
Okay, why? What am I going for, the steak? What
why?
Am I,
yeah, have you tried the barbecue?
I'm telling you, I haven't, so I need to.
That's why you don't know
right,
why.
Okay, I'm gonna try the barbecue,
why.
Okay.
Like, if you had tried before, it would just be like, yeah, I know
oh, no.
that, but like, what else?
Okay, I got barbecue, okay, what, yeah. So give
the
me
barbecue,
something else.
I mean feijoada.
Which is what?
It's basically rice and beans, but the beans they are made in a way that you have like a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah.
And,
it's tasty.
Yeah, it's really tasty. And you have like a lot of like pork things going on, like you gotta try it.
So that's
I don't even know how to speak in English, you know.
No, it's hard to translate. But okay,
yeah.
So that's my main course. What's for dessert? What's for the afters?
I'm not a dessert guy.
You're not?
Yeah.
So you're a starter and a main?
Yeah, I'm
okay.
Never, like, this is something, like, I don't like sweets at all.
Okay, we got it. I'm going to the restaurant. You can take
yeah,
me.
Yeah.
All right, Zeb, we're out. Thanks, enjoy Tomorrowland Brazil.
Thanks so much.
And I'll see you very soon. And congratulations on the Wiz Khalifa collaboration. Yeah, we found that out, come on.